and welcome to this special presentation on Rajya Sabha television from inside the Parliament House complex. This is Question Hour, a show in which we bring you the details of the questions asked and the answers given during the session of the Parliament. And this time around, it will be from the just concluded monsoon session of Parliament. So let's have a look in the next half an hour on some important questions from several ministries, including civil aviation, home and labor and employment, and some others from day one of the monsoon session. And with me is my colleague, Kriti Mishra.
Thank you, Vishal. So let's take our viewers through important questions and the answers.
Well, yes, Kriti, and let's begin with an important question from one of the members, Sukhram Singh, who goes on to ask the government whether a decline is being recorded in the employment growth rate in the country, due to which workers of unorganized sectors along with educated people are getting lesser employment opportunities.
The sarkar ne kaha ki hum 5 crore logon ko rozgar denge. 5 crore logon mein se lagbhag 4 saal hone ja rahe hain, iske anusar lagbhag 20 crore logon ko rozgar mil jana chahiye tha. Main jana chahta hu mani mantri se ki kya jo vaade kiye the uske mutabik.
Well, Vishal, responding to the queries raised by the members Sukhram Singh Yadav, Labour and Employment Minister Santosh Gangwar apprised the upper house that job opportunities have not come down in the country, and even global data shows that unemployment rate in India is low.
दुनिया का आप डाटा देखें तो दुनिया के डाटा में सबसे कम बेरोजगारी का आंकड़ा हमारे देश का है, बाकी पड़ोसी देशों का सबसे ज्यादा है. मैं यहाँ ये बताना चाहूँगा कि विभिन्न सेक्टर्स में एम्प्लॉयमेंट बढ़ने घटने का कोई प्रश्न नहीं है. प्राप्त आंकड़ों के अनुसार प्राइमरी सेक्टर, जिसे कृषि एवं अन्य क्षेत्र कहते हैं, वहां पर एम्प्लॉयमेंट कम हुआ है. और इसके अलावा सेकेंडरी सेक्टर, जो उद्योग धंधे और टर्शरी सेक्टर जिसमें सेवा क्षेत्र शामिल हैं, इसमें एम्प्लॉयमेंट बढ़ा है. रोजगार के अवसर कहीं पर भी कम नहीं हुए हैं, और ऐसे कई अवसर हैं जो हमने, हमारी सरकार ने चालू किए हैं. प्रधानमंत्री रोजगार गारंटी योजना, मनरेगा, दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्रामीण कौशल विकास योजना, ये एक क्षेत्र है. मनरेगा में पिछले 4 वर्षों में 2014 से 18 के बीच में जो धनराशि उपयोग में लाई गई वो 1,73,000 करोड़ रुपए थी, और मैन डेज 871 करोड़ दिवस हुए थे.
Well, Kriti, apart from the first member, Anand Sharma asked a supplementary question to this, he asked Santosh Gangwar whether 1/3 micro, small and medium enterprises have shut down between November 2016 and November 2017, leading to 4 crore losses to the jobs.
जो इन्होंने अभी सदन में कहा कि मनरेगा के लिए पैसा बढ़ा, उसका सबसे बड़ा कारण है कि शहरों में नौकरी और कस्बों में नौकरी खत्म हो गई थी, रोजगार बंद हुआ. ये मंत्री महोदय बताने की कृपा करें कि क्या ये सच है या गलत है कि 1/3 जो माइक्रो, स्मॉल और मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेज हैं 2016 नवंबर के बाद और पिछले साल नवंबर तक बंद हुए हैं देश में, जिसमें लगभग 4 करोड़ रोजगार टूट गया. ये आपके पास इसकी जानकारी है या नहीं?
Well, Vishal, Santosh Gangwar responded to this one as well. Let's listen.
हम लोगों ने जिस प्रकार से स्वरोजगार की दिशा में काम किया है, उसके परिणाम अब सामने आ रहे हैं. 2015-16 में हमने जो टारगेट रखा था, उससे ज़्यादा पैसा दिया और हर वर्ष बढ़ाने का काम किया है, और ये वास्तव में छोटे छोटे उद्यमियों को आगे बढ़ने की दिशा में कदम है.
Well, the next one on the same ministry is from D. Kupendra Reddy, who goes on to ask the government whether it is a fact that post amendments to the Maternity Benefit Act entitling working women to 26-week paid leave, the women employees or laborers' participation rate dwindled considerably during the current year in comparison to previous years.
Well, Labour Minister Santosh Gangwar says that no such data is maintained by central government. The government is of the opinion that with the enforcement of Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017, more and more women workers would be inclined to seek employment, which will lead to increase in women labour participation. The Maternity Benefit Act 1961 is enforced and implemented by the respective state governments in all sectors except in mines and circus industries. Time to time, advisories are also issued to state governments for strict enforcement and compliance of the provisions of the Maternity Benefit Act 1961. Moving on to the Ministry of Home Affairs now, and member Shamshed Singh Dhallo asked whether crimes against persons belonging to scheduled castes and scheduled tribes have increased, and also whether legal protection is provided to victims and families of these communities.
जो क्राइम जो है शेड्यूल कास्टों के खिलाफ चाहे रेप का हो चाहे एट्रॉसिटी की बात हो चाहे मर्डर के हों डिफरेंट ट्राइब के चाहे रिलीजियस मामले हों
Well, this was an important question, Kriti, and answered by the Home Minister himself. Indeed, we saw several supplementaries being asked by several members. So let's begin with the response of the Home Minister, who goes on to say that the government was committed to uplifting and empowering the people belonging to scheduled castes. He also said that the Act and rules to protect the rights of the SCs have been strengthened. Let's listen in detail, the Home Minister.
कि एससी एसटी कम्युनिटी के लोगों को भारत के संविधान के द्वारा जो भी प्रोटेक्शन उपलब्ध है उसे न कोई संस्था छीन सकती है न कोई दूसरे देश का कोई व्यक्ति छीन सकता है. मैं पूरी तरह से आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं और हमारी सरकार ने एससी एसटी एक्ट में किसी भी प्रकार का डाइल्यूशन न होने पाए और इसके लिए जो कुछ भी किया जा सकता है उस हमारी सरकार ने किया है. यानी एससी एसटी जो एक्ट है उसको और अधिक स्ट्रेंथन करने के लिए जो भी अमेंडमेंट्स आवश्यक थे वो सारे अमेंडमेंट्स एक्ट में करने का काम हमारी सरकार ने किया है. केवल एक्ट में ही अमेंडमेंट नहीं किया है बल्कि रूल्स में भी हमारी सरकार ने अमेंडमेंट किया है ताकि एससी एसटी कम्युनिटी को भारत के संविधान के द्वारा जो भी प्रोटेक्शन प्राप्त है उस पर किसी भी सूरत में कोई सवालिया निशान न लगा सके इस बात को ध्यान में रखते हुए.
The independent member, Dr. Narendra Jadhav, also asked the minister about the increase in number of crimes on SC/ST women and the conviction rate of the same.
There is a question whether there has been or to what extent there has been an increase in the number of crimes against scheduled caste, scheduled tribe women and what is the conviction rate as far as the cases against scheduled caste, about the cases. Scheduled caste, scheduled tribe women, what is the conviction rate and how does it compare with the general cases registered under Indian Penal Code?
Minister. Thank you.
Hansraj Ahir said, who's MOS home, that NCRP does not have women-specific data but added that the government is committed to the protection of women.
जो भी अपराध महिलाओं पे होते हो और किसी प्रकार के होते हो इसके अलग से उसकी एंट्री या उसका अलग डाटा नहीं बनता है एनसीआरपी के माध्यम से. लेकिन ये बात सही है कि सरकार इसके प्रति से हमारे मंत्री बहुदेव ने कहा है कि एससी एसटी के प्रति सरकार बहुत संवेदनशीलता से काम करती है और हमने ऐसे अपराध ना बढ़े इसके लिए जो अमेंडमेंट लाए थे उसके अनुसार न्यायालय भी बढ़े हुए हैं और राज्य सरकारों को भी बार बार एडवाइजरी जाती है और इसे अपराध ना बढ़े इसके लिए सूचना भेजी जाती है राज्य सरकार को काम करवाया जाता है.
Well, there were other members as well who participated in the debate. Manoj Jha of RJD said that atrocities on SCSTs continue, including manual scavenging, on which the minister replied that the government is committed to take action against manual scavenging as per the 2015 amendment.
70 वर्ष में बहुत कुछ शायद ना हुआ होगा, लेकिन कमाल की बात है सर, सीवर में उतर करके उतरने वाले की जाति नहीं बदली सर. मंगलयान पे हम चले गए लेकिन सीवर में उतरने वाले की जाति नहीं बदली सर. ये तो कष्ट का विषय है हम सब के लिए, चाहे हम किसी भी दल में हों.
सरकार इस तरीके से महिला ढोने की प्रथा से लेके हर चीज के प्रति सरकार गंभीर है और ऐसा भी अगर कोई काम करवाता है गंदा तो उसके खिलाफ में भी कार्रवाई करने का 2015 के जो हमने अमेंडमेंट लाया उसमें प्रावधान किया हुआ है.
Well, the next question, Kriti, is from the member CM Ramesh, who goes on to ask the government about its proposals, or rather actions the government proposes to take to build confidence amongst women in the country, something related to women's security.
Well, Vishal, the government has given a very comprehensive answer. And Minister MOS Home Affairs, Hansraj Gangaram Ahir, says that government has undertaken a project for developing an emergency response support system based on a pan-India 24/7 helpline number 112 and accessible through call, SMS, email and panic buttons. Government has also issued advisories to states and union territories to make measures for prevention of crime against women, stressing on mandatory registration of FIRs, providing online complaint filing system, increasing representation of women in police, gender sensitization of police, deployment of special Mahila police volunteers and setting up of anti-human trafficking units. Moreover, government has approved safe city projects for 8 cities to put in place comprehensive infrastructure technological and community-based interventions for women's safety. Government has also commenced development of a national database on sexual offenders to facilitate investigation and tracking of sexual offenders across the country. That's quite a comprehensive answer.
Well, yes, indeed. It details all the steps which have been taken by the government so far, or it has advised the state governments to go ahead and ensure the safety of women.
Moving on to the next question, and this one has been asked by K. Ravindra Kumar, and he asks whether government has formulated any scheme to reduce overcrowding of district-level prisons across the country. This issue is certainly very important. In fact, the Supreme Court has also constituted a panel.
This one is also answered by the Minister of State for Home Affairs, Hansraj Gangaram Ahir, who goes on to answer the question by saying, as on 31st of December 2016, the overall occupancy rate of district jails in the country is 128.3%. Now, prisons is a state subject under List 2 of the 7th Schedule of the Constitution. However, the Government of India has issued advisories to state government and UT administrations with regard to prison administration and prison management. A model prison manual 2016 has been forwarded to all states and Union Territories, which provides for measures to be taken to reduce overcrowding in prisons. The Government of India has also taken various administrative and legislative measures which may contribute in reducing overcrowding in prisons. Some of the initiatives taken are introduction of the concept of plea bargaining through Section 265A of CRPC, insertion of a new section with 436A in the CRPC on the maximum period for which an under-trial prisoner can be detained, etc. So all these are the steps, Kriti, which have been taken by the government to ensure that, this overcrowding of prisons is dealt with in one way or the other. Now, the next one is from Shri A. Vijay Kumar, who goes on to ask the government whether it is aware of the growing incidence of anti-nationalism in the country in the name of freedom of expression, whether government has any proposal to change sedition law to crack down on such incidents.
Well, this is a very important answer given by the government, and the Ministry of Home Affairs has written to the Ministry of Law and Justice to request the Law Commission of India to study the usage of the provisions of Section 124A, sedition of IPC, and suggest amendments, if any. The Law Commission has undertaken the examination of the section and is considering the scope and ambit of the law on sedition in order to ascertain under what circumstances it can legitimately be invoked. A draft report on the subject has been prepared and discussed, deliberated in the Law Commission's meeting held on 26th of June 2018, and as decided, the same is being reviewed. The report is yet to be finalised by the Law Commission.
Well, that is indeed a detailed one from the government on this important question as well.
Well, time for a short break now. Important questions and their answers on the other side. Stay tuned.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Welcome back, you're watching Question Hour. Moving on to the next important question, and this one has been asked by Chaya Verma, and she asks whether aviation companies are selling each seat at the time of boarding after booking journey tickets.
क्या वैध टिकट होने के उपरांत भी यात्रियों से सीट के एवज में अतिरिक्त राशि लेना जायज है और यदि जायज है तो उसे टिकट में क्यों समाहित नहीं किया जाता?
That's a very important question for all the air travelers.
Well, yes, indeed, and this has been debated in public domain as well for quite some time. And the MOS Civil Aviation Jayant Sinha has responded to this question by saying that the government has made the air pricing mechanism transparent and non-discriminatory. However, it is the contract between the airline and customer that determines the commercial aspect. Let's listen into the exact statement of the minister.
ये जो फेयर्स थे इनको
डीरेगुलेट सुनिए बाद में
फेयर्स को डीरेगुलेट कर दिया गया था और हम लोगों ने कुछ सिद्धांत थे जो उनको हम लोगों ने स्पष्ट किया है वो सिद्धांत हैं ऑप्ट इन के पारदर्शिता के और नॉन डिस्क्रिमिनेशन के तो ये ऑप्ट इन ट्रांसपेरेंसी और नॉन डिस्क्रिमिनेशन प्रिंसिपल्स को लेकर आपके और एयरलाइन के बीच में जो समझौता जो कमर्शियल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट बनता है उसके आधार पे फिर टर्म्स ऑफ कैरेज होते हैं और उसके आधार पे फिर आप फ्लाइट सर्विसेज का उपयोग कर सकते हैं
Interestingly, Member Tiruchi Siva called for doing away of the seat allotment scheme to prevent discrimination among passengers and asked for first-come, first-served basis. He also suggested the minister to fix a ceiling for airfares during high demand. Take a listen.
See, these preferred seats give a feel that there is a discrimination among the passengers. Why don't you kindly do away with this scheme because first-come, first-served basis if it is adopted, I think that would help and depart is another thing, sir. At the time of the departure of the flight, the fares are increased 400%, sir. See, you can allow them to increase the fares as per the demand, but it should not be abnormal. So fix a ceiling at least. Sometimes if it is 4,000, it is 16,000 and 18,000 for a smaller sector. And people who are in a hurry and who are in distress face a lot of trouble.
Right.
So I would like to know from the minister.
It is a suggestion for action. Let him take
note. The ministry intervene to fix a ceiling that it should not exceed 200% or something like that.
Well, Kriti, the next one is from the member D. Kupendra Reddy, who goes on to ask the government whether it has taken any steps to introduce internet and calling facilities for the flyers on board in domestic airlines, an important one which everybody is waiting for.
Rather very important, and MOS Civil Aviation, Jayant Sinha says that the government has decided to provide in-flight connectivity for calling and internet facilities. The implementation through licensed service providers requires necessary approvals from the Department of Telecommunication and other government agencies. The same is under consideration of Department of Telecommunication. Moving on to the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas now, and member T. Ratnavel has asked whether it is a fact that ONGC Videsh Limited and its partners have acquired a 10% stake in a large offshore field in Abu Dhabi for $600 million.
Well, the government goes on to answer this, Kriti, by giving the details that on 10th of February 2018, Indian consortium comprising ONGC Videsh, Indian Oil Corporation Limited and Bharat Petro Resources Limited acquired 10% participating interest in Lower Zakum offshore oil field from Abu Dhabi National Oil Company of UAE at a cost of $600 million. The agreements in this regard have been signed and are valid for a period of 40 years. The next one is from Shri Javed Ali Khan, who goes on to ask the government about the number of gas connections released under the Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana.
And the government has given a very precise answer, and it says that as on 13th of July 2018, oil marketing companies have released more than 4.65 crore LPG connections under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. OMCs have reported that average refill consumption pattern of a beneficiary is more than 3.5 cylinders in a year. The beneficiaries are enrolled under PEHEL scheme, wherein the applicable LPG subsidy on purchase of refill, which happens at non-subsidized price, is directly transferred into their bank accounts. So certainly there are no leakages.
Well, the next one, Kriti, is from Member T. Ratnavel, who goes on to ask the government about the problems faced in WTO regarding India's food security. So let's listen in as to what is the response from the minister concerned here.
India is facing before the WTO is about food security. The developed nation like the US has refused to agree to the demand of developing nations and the food security. Initially, India was bargaining hard for improving and an already available mechanism and that safeguards government purchase of staple food grain from low income and resource poor farmers at subsidies prices for stockpiling and then distributing them to the countries economically weak. So I would like to know from the honorable minister, what is the stand of WTO and India's food security. Thank you.
WTO जो है आपके स्टॉक पाइलिंग के ऊपर कई दिन कई समय से चल रहा है. कुछ डेवलप्ड कंट्री चाहते हैं कि स्टॉक पाइलिंग करने से अनाज का स्टॉक पाइलिंग करने से स्टॉकिंग करने से स्टॉक होल्डिंग करने से इसकी प्राइसेस पे इंटरनेशनल मार्केट पे असर आना. लेकिन जितने डेवलपिंग नेशन और लिस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज़ हैं उनका ये कहना है कि फॉर द फूड सिक्योरिटी फॉर द पुअर पीपल दिस पब्लिक प्रोक्योरमेंट इज मस्ट गवर्नमेंट प्रोक्योर करती है और उनको अपने अपने सिस्टम से जैसे भारत में पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम है थ्रू राशन शॉप्स हैं वी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द फूड. हमने एक इनफॉर्मल मिनिस्टर मीटिंग भी हुई है यहाँ पे 1920 मार्च को जिसमें करीब 53 कंट्रीज पार्टिसिपेटेड इन इंडिया दिल्ली के अंदर हुई थी. डेवोस के अंदर जनवरी के अंदर हुई है. तो मेरा निवेदन था कि ये बिल्कुल सही है वाजिब बात है कि आप जो स्टॉकिंग जो कर रहे हैं पब उनका कहना है कि आप सब्सिडाइज या काफ़ी पैसा देके लो प्राइसेस पे खरीदते हैं देन यू सेल ऑन द वेरी हाईली सब्सिडाइज टू द फार्मर दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम विद द डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज.
बलरत्न विल फर्दर आस्क्ड व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ अश्योरेंसेस इंडिया हैज फ्रॉम अदर नेशंस टू प्रोटेक्ट इट्स ट्रेड इंटरेस्ट.
व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ अश्योरेंस वी गॉट फ्रॉम दिस नेशंस टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड ट्रेड इंटरेस्ट्स ऑफ नेशन लाइक अवर्स. थैंक यू.
यूनिलैटरल डिसीजंस होने लगे हैं किसी प्रकार से. WTO के जो आपका मल्टीलेटरल सिस्टम को थोड़ा सा डिस्टोर्ट करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं तो बाकी कंट्रीज चाहे वो 11th मिनिस्ट्रियल कॉन्फ्रेंस हो चाहे वो इंडिया में इनफॉर्मल गैदरिंग हो चाहे वो डेवोस में इनफॉर्मल गैदरिंग हो चाहे पेरिस में 31 मई को इनफॉर्मल गैदरिंग ऑफ द मिनिस्टर्स हो एवरीवेयर दिस इवन आई अटेंडेड दिस ब्रिक कॉमर्स एंड ट्रेड मिनिस्टर्स कॉन्फ्रेंस एट नियर जॉन्सबर्ग. तो उस वहाँ पे भी ये डिस्कस हुआ था मैं ऑल द ब्रिक कंट्री भी इस बात से थे कि डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज जो हैं आप प्रोटेक्शनिज्म की नीति नहीं अपनाए.
Moving on to the Ministry of Textiles now, and member Sanjay Raut asked the textile minister about what the government is doing for providing jobs and training to textile workers of Mumbai who have lost their jobs.
जो textile worker बेरोजगार हो गए लाखों और उनके बच्चे भी बेरोजगार हो गए, क्या आप उस textile worker जो बेरोजगार है उनके लिए आपकी जो नई स्कीम है उनके माध्यम से कोई employment की या उनको ट्रेनिंग देने की कोई स्कीम आप बना सकते हैं?
Well, there is a detailed answer which has been given by the Minister of State for Textile, Ajay Tamta. Let's listen into what Ajay Tamta has to say.
क्योंकि आपने बोला कि विभाग के द्वारा कोई नई योजना मंत्रालय ने विचार किया है, क्योंकि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी के मार्गदर्शन में और हम एक नई योजना जिसकी शुरुआत हम बहुत जल्दी करने वाले हैं समर्थ के रूप में और उसकी कार्रवाई और उसकी एक पारदर्शी प्रक्रिया भी हमने अपनाई है और उस पारदर्शी प्रक्रिया के अनुसार इसकी इसमें हमने 1300 करोड़ रुपए का परिव्यय भी रखा है और जो 2017 से लेकर 2020 तक इस योजना का लाभ मिलेगा और 10 लाख लोगों को हम इसमें स्किल करेंगे.
So, Kriti, that was it this week we had for our viewers in terms of the questions which were asked on day one of the monsoon session.
Well, absolutely, Vishal. So, next week, we'll bring more important questions and their answers given by the government. That's all we had for you in this edition of Question Hour. Stay tuned to Rajya Sabha TV.